Hello everyone, welcome to my another Photoshop tutorial. In this video I'll show you how to merge two photos together using Photoshop. I have already another video about it, but some people were asking me to show more details about it. That's why I'm making this tutorial. I've designed very much for the beginners. You know, for this sort of work we need two or more images. You can apply multiple number of images if you want. So let's start. Go to file and select create a new Photoshop document. Select new. You can resize it wide. I'm keeping wide 1400 and height 1000. Then click OK. The new document created. Now create a new layer. Go to layer, select new and create a new layer. Click OK. New layer created here. Now change the foreground color to white and background color to black. Just click here and reverse it. Now select gradient tool and click here on gradient and select this gradient, then click OK. Now select radial gradient here. Now drag with your mouse from middle to bottom corner of your document and apply the gradient effect. Now open one of your image. Go to file and open, find your image and open it. Now select polygonal lasso tool and keep feather settings 0.5 pixels. Now start selecting your image. Remember the point where you from starting selecting the image, your end point will be the same. I'm starting from this point, my endpoint will be here. You can use plus button on keyboard to make bigger size image or minus button for lower size image during selection. If you accidentally select anywhere else, press delete button on your keyboard and go back to your previous point and start selecting again. I'm almost my starting point. If I click on my starting point, it will be selected. I'm gonna click on my starting point here. Here you can see it's selected now. Use zoom minus to make it lower size. Now you can see it. Now go to edit and select copy. Now go back your background. Select background here. Now go to edit and select paste. Now select move tool and take it, move it anywhere here or there. Now go to edit again and select free transform. You can resize it, you can make it bigger or lower like this. Then click on this confirmation mark. Here is a problem with this image. Look, there is background came along with the image. We need to clear it. So select polygonal lasso tool again and start selecting this area. Now go to edit and select clear. It's cleared now. Now go to select and choose deselect. Now use your zoom tool to resize it. Now open another image. Now select polygonal lasso tool and start selecting this image like previous one. I have already selected this image, so that's why I'm not going to show you here again. Here is the selected image. So after selecting this, go to edit and select copy, then go back your background. Now go to edit and select paste. Select move tool and take it here. Now go to edit and select free transform. Or you can simply do that. Press Ctrl and T on your keyboard to free transform. Then click on this confirmation mark. I'll show you another thing. Select free transform again and go to edit and select transform to flip horizontal. Here you go, it's flipped horizontally. Now click on this confirmation mark and move it here or there, anywhere. You can see this image is front because this layer is top of all layers. If you take this layer top, then it will be front. You can see here like this. I'm going to take it top. Here is, you can see that now it's in front. If I take this image top, then it will be front. Now you can save it. Go to file, select save as, and I'm gonna saving it JPEG format. You can save any format you would like. Then rename it and save. Now I'm gonna show you another trick. I'll take this image to this image and merge them together. Just go back and select this image I have already selected, then go to edit and select copy. Now go to this image and go to edit and select paste. Now take it here. Now go to edit and select free transform. And you can make it bigger. After done resizing it, click on this confirmation mark and you can save it as well. Go to File, Save As. Select any format you would like to save. That's it now. If my tutorial helps you, please like, comment and subscribe me. If you have any question regarding this tutorial, feel free to ask. I would be glad to answer you. Thanks for watching.